Ladies and gentlemen, from the halls and classrooms of Bucyrus High School, and under the direction of Mr. Ron Reisinger, assisted by Alex Zoll, Trent Cornell, and Kurt Shifley, with field direction provided by Ms. Kim Wallmeyer and Ms. Peter Winsinger, we proudly present the Pride of the Redmen, the 120-unit Marching Redmen Band. Ladies and gentlemen, we live in a great country with freedoms like no other. To honor America and respect for this great country, will you please rise for the playing of our national anthem? Thank you. 1893 was a season of extremes. While relentless rain showers inundated the Midwest, a searing drought of record temperature was cast upon the Ohio Valley. Central Ohio caught 70 mile per hour winds during mid-July in the summer's worst thunder squall. And Hurricane Emily buffeted the Outer Banks of North Carolina with high winds and pounding storm surge. With a cool, comforting stillness of autumn upon us, the mere recollection of the suffocating heat of band camp makes even the most rugged marching redmen just want to scream. It's the dry season now, with great expanses of dead brown grass and some bleached bones lying before us. Immense herds of grazing animals kick up dense clouds of dust in their search for the few remaining blades of grass. Off in the distance, the faint sound of drums can be heard as restless and wild natives in gaily colored ceremonial costume dance to the choreography of John Steeple in Wildebeest. and more recently made popular by the movie Wayne's World, here's senior trumpet player Amy Thornton and Reverend Majorette Shamar Asad in Bohemian Rhapsody. In this next number by Bruce Broughton, you can almost hear the jingle of spurs and smell the saddle leather. Feel the sun and the wind on your face as the 120 marching redmen take you across the border in Silverado. Thank you. seats, because here's Redmond feature twirler, Shamara Samad, in Hold On. Just in case that wasn't enough, here's a Redmond auxiliary to combine their own flair and color movement in this brassy and bluesy Tom Wallace arrangement of Funky Broadway.
Thank you.
Redmond Auxiliary Entertainment with a magic play of their own, with an encounter between Good Evil and Mr. Pitbull.
Time out here for a commercial.
Bear with me. I'm off for a commercial. My voice is about headed, so I'm going to try to make this brief. The band parents did a very, very nice thing this year, something a little new for us. They put together a program. I hope a number of you got the opportunity to get one. Those of you that are parents, most of you are parents. It would be a nice keepsake. There's some nice pictures you've had. There's some all over the back of the band camp and so on. So we hope that you enjoy the program. Most of the thank yous and duties done that I'm trying to do up here, we've tried to cover in the program so I don't have to spend as much time up here. However, I can't let it go without saying some specific thank yous. First of all, I would like to draw attention to a right-hand man and a gentleman who does some arranging for the band, does some show design through the season, and is a top-notch musician, does a great job at the middle school, Mr. Scheinman. Great to stand up here. Also on the staff is a gentleman that has done wonders with a specific section in this band and continues to do wonders with them. This is, in most marching bands, the percussion section is probably maybe halfway down as far as the size of each section would go as far as having the numbers. Not in this band, they're one of the largest sections in the band, and that's the percussion section, and that's due to a young man, oh gosh. That'll cost you. Gentleman by the name of Trent Cornell. Trent, stand up. Also, putting the final touches to this organization of the auxiliaries, which had a lot of color, a lot of excitement, a lot of design to it, and that's headed up by a young lady by the name of Allison Zoll. Allison, up here, you can't hide that. Here she is. Her right-hand person is a woman that has done more than just work with them and practice with them. She sews a lot of their uniforms, looks after them. She is all of their... She serves as the second mother to this whole squad, and that's Sharon Norfolk. Sharon, step up. And also, I'd like to draw attention. This year, we've been blessed again with having the voice of the marching regiment along again with us this season, and that's Mr. John Hillman behind me here. John, stand up.
Organization here at Bucyrus is fantastic. It
a second seat to no one else around. And I want to thank the Panthers organization. They are headed up by the officers, Mr. George Funk is president, Carol Griffin is vice president, Karen James is treasurer, and Bill Hillebrand is secretary. Can we give the Panthers a round of applause?
I know he gets frustrated a lot of the time, but he still puts up with us And I know after a lot of rehearsals, after he's been on his feet all day long, and he's been outside marching around us trying to teach us things, which sometimes isn't very easy, he gets really, really tired, and he likes to come inside and relax. But this chair is all he has at his desk for him to relax in. Now, it doesn't look very comfortable to me, and I know that he doesn't look very comfortable.
Doing a fine job. and I couldn't help but when I was in Purdue just a couple weeks ago, and as a guest of the band, and with the band, I get a tear in my eye when I see someone from Bucyrus in that band. Okay, now, we're ready.
We have one more surprise for you guys here. Monday is his birthday, so...
In the fall of 1990, the March of Redmond performed performed the first dance, choreographed by Bucyrus graduate and a Ohio University band member, Tim Owens, to the sounds of Redmond percussion. Tim became a member of the United States Marines Drum and Bugle Corps, and dancing became the earmark of the marching Redmond style. In recognition of our distinguished and dedicated alumnus, we take a moment now to honor our American brothers and sisters on duty in war-torn Somalia. It takes raw courage and uncommon valor to leave the comfort, security of home and to live with danger as a constant companion. Since risk and patriotism go hand in hand, from sunny Lexington Green to the blackened oil fields of Kuwait, the American GI has had a style all his own. Here with a style all their own are the marching redmen and percussion as they cut loose with Black Sand. When you're hot, you're hot. But when you're really cooking, there's just no keeping quiet. Now it's time for Redmond Auxiliary to beat their own gong and strut their own stuff in Bang a Gong, Get It On.
Special didn't know that. We'd like very much to take some time to recognize some people from the stands for a change. And to do that, we have our assistant principal, Mr. Chuck Campbell. Chuck.
We recognize Vivian for her many hours of dedication.
appreciate it. Thank you.
Denny Roy, this was supposed to have been presented last year, but Denny was busy, I believe, with National Guard at the time, so we were not able to extend this to him at that particular time. We're not doing this at this time. Denny has assisted our training program in two specific areas. The Gatlinburg trip was planned in Denny's office last year. Every detail was looked into, and they managed to plan the tour that was very enjoyable and appreciated by all. Additionally, Denny provided the band a fundraising opportunity during the AAA's open house this past year. The band Bucyrus were able to raise approximately $500 as a result of this opportunity. Many thanks to Denny for all of his efforts. Thanks very much, Denny.
Thank you. Thank you.
1993 marching season is almost a memory, Redmond seniors reflect on another pile of events that have their senior scrapbook. There were the good times, the Americorps parade, the Church of Gatlinburg, performing before a million spectators on Thanksgiving Day in Detroit, the winning football seasons, and putting away the uniform at the end of the season, knowing that only a few months will be another time to date out for another season. But then there was the stinging chill of the playoff game at Arnold Field. The memories of shows prepared in bad weather, and times for studying, living, rehearsing, performing, living, rehearsing, studying, performing, just didn't fit into 1 week. And tonight, the uniform will be put away for the last time. But just like senior soloists Jody Graham, Cheryl Eichhorn, Amy Morris, and senior auxiliary can tell you, it's all worthwhile just to have friends. Before we close tonight's program, I would like again to say to the band, thank you for allowing me to be your announcement. You're a wonderful group of young people, and I'd like to say once more to the audience, thank you for your kind attention. So tonight we close the season with the same music we started it with, just in case you think that this band's on sentimental. Here's Money. Miss Kara Murphy, we proudly present the pride of the Redmen, the 120-unit Marching Redmen Band. Ha ha.